This is a short introduction video for the MoBA Simulator for Excel 2018.1 by TLK-Thermo. After you run the installer, you will find the MoBA Simulator in the ribbon menu of Excel. To get started, you can either create a new sheet for a single simulation or you can create a new sheet for a parameter variation. I will now start with a single simulation and later I will show the parameter variation. Okay, I will now select an FMU and I can see how the sheet is generated. On the top of the sheet I see the full file path of the FMU. In the left side you can see all parameters. In the center you see the timetable for the inputs. And on the right side you see the space where the parameters, the simulation results will be copied after the simulation. So to start a simulation you can now just click the simulate button and you see the log window shows and the progress bar shows the current progress. The simulation is finished within 5 seconds. Okay. To change the input table you just have to change the values here, and to change a parameter you have to change the values here. If I now press the simulate button, the simulation is restarted and the simulation results will be updated. Oh, this is an error message by the FMU. Actually this is an assert statement by the TIL library. So there's flow reversal at the compressor. Maybe I have to change the inputs to make it a little more realistic. Okay, I will rerun the simulation. And this time it finishes. Okay, to plot the results you can simply use Excel. You select the time column and by pressing Control you can also select the simulation results, insert an XY plot, and here you see the simulation results. Okay, if you now want to change the sheet you can open the simulation setup also in the current sheet group of the ribbon menu. This is the main dialog of this tool. You have a tab for the inputs. The checkbox is checked when it is visible on the sheet. You also have a tab for the parameters. There you can see all parameters currently visible on the sheet and you can select or deselect them. And I now just want to add two more outputs, the COP and the electrical power. I'm using this search filter on the top to filter the variables displayed in the lower part of that window, and then I select the checkbox. Okay, if I now press OK the sheet will be updated and you can see that there are new outputs on the sheet. You can also change the parameter values in this parameter dialog. So these are text edits and you can change the values. Okay, if you rerun the simulation you will see the additional results also in the Excel sheet. Okay, I will now show how to set up a parameter variation. This is not just one single simulation, it's a certain number of simulations. I again have to select an FMU. And now this sheet is generated. It looks a bit different. On the top you see the full file path of the FMU, the start time and stop time, and the number of grid points that should be calculated in between. And there's a timeout if you want to stop the simulation if it takes too long. You see the description of the variations in this section. So there are currently three variations and they are all active. Okay, and now you see the section for our parameters, which is really big. I will now remove all parameters, and now you see that below the section for the parameters, there's also a section for the inputs and for the simulation results. Okay, I will now change the compressor speed of the high pressure level compressor. And if I now press the simulate button, this first variation is simulated, then the second variation with 25 rotations per second, and then the third variation. In the log window you can see the variation 1 is started, it's finished after 5.3 seconds, variation 2 is finished after 5.6 seconds. And the third variation is finished after 6.6 seconds. Here you see the simulation results. Okay, this success tells you that the simulation was successful. You can, if it's not successful, it says failed. And if you cancel the simulation by pressing the abort button in the log window, it will be aborted, written in that cell. Okay, going back to the single simulation, I'm now going to show you a bit more about the simulation setup. In the simulation setup you will find you will also find the model information. This information tells you that this is a 2.0 FMU, that it supports model exchange and co-simulation, that it supports 32-bit and 64-bits. And this is an important information. This FMU requires an external library, which is the TLMedia 350.dll. And this DLL is not included in this FMU, so if you run it on another computer, it will not work properly. The model icon is the model PNG in the FMU itself. This one is the diagram view, which was exported by Dymola. There's also a documentation which can be shown in the browser. Just click it and the browser opens, and then you can see the documentation of the FMU. You see the original model name in Modelica, that this model was exported by Dymola version 2018 FD01. And down here you also see the detailed information about the capability flags and the number of continuous states, even indicators, and so on. So this FMU supports set and get state and serialized state, for instance. Okay, additionally to this model information you will find the experiment setup in this dialog. This tells me that the FMU was operated in co-simulation. So you can also choose to set this to model exchange, and then you have to select the solver for the differential equations. We have an implementation of the Sun Dials CV ODE and an implementation of the ARC ODE available, and also an explicit Euler solver. You can set all these solver parameters down here. You find the information that in model exchange mode you will have a linear interpolation of the inputs, and you can also export the simulation results as MAT file. Okay, another interesting feature, if you're running this simulation as model exchange, then you can press F5 during the simulation and see the intermediate information about the solver statistics, the number of F evaluations, and so on. So F5 is the button to update this solver statistics information in the log window. I've now shown how to open an FMU and run a simulation with it, but this interface can also be used for dymosim executables, in case you want to run exactly the model that you're running in Dymola, because sometimes the FMU export is not perfectly implemented and the results will be a little bit different, and that could be a problem. So for that reason we also offer the option to open dymosim executables directly, or if you just want to open a MUT file, so to load results into this interface, then you can also open a MUT file or a Dymola result file. I will now show that I can also open this dymosim executable of this very model. I can select the outputs the same way I did for the FMU, and I can run the simulation. The input table is generated, automatically filled, and here you see the log of the simulation. It took 1.2 seconds. Okay. I forgot to change the inputs, and the experiment setup is not included in the dymosim executable, so for that reason it was not exactly the same simulation time. So if I rerun the simulation with the same simulation time, same inputs, then it should take 4 seconds, around 4 seconds. Oh, 5.4 seconds, however. Okay, and here you see the simulation results. I don't have to prepare this model in any way, it's just an executable which was generated in Dymola with top-level inputs. Okay, I can also load the MUT file. I will show this here. This is a result file of a simulation in Dymola. Of course there are no parameters for this MUT file, but I still can select the COP again. Oh, it is already selected. And I have to press the simulate button to update the outputs in the sheet, but basically this is the way how you can access the values. Okay, another way to you can also open FMUs from other sources. So for instance, this is an FMU generated by the FMU export kit by Dassault. There's also the Simulink model image included in the FMU. You see that there's a dependency to the runtime libraries by Microsoft, and you see the FMU kit version down here. And of course these FMUs can be executed the same way, so this is a nice way how you get your Simulink models into Excel. So these I now showed an FMU from Dymola and from Simulink, but there are many other sources, and we try to support as many tools as possible. So please check our cross-check results on the FMI homepage, and we hope that you will be able to simulate your models with the MoBA Simulator. So much for the first introduction.